about different food sources for bacteria and their classification based on their food sources. The first food source is carbohydrates, and as in carbohydrates, they take carbon as a food source, and if they take as an inorganic carbon, then they are known as autotrophs. And if they take as an organic carbon compounds as a sole source of carbohydrates, then they are known as heterotrophs. And second source is energy. Energy is used as in light as well as indirect energy, chemical sources. Then if they use energy as a light, then they are known as phototrophs. And chemicals are generally organic as well as inorganic. And both organic as well as inorganic chemical compounds are used as an energy source material for bacteria, then these bacteria are known as chemotrophs. Then the third source is hydrogen as well as electrons. These are donors for bacteria, and bacteria accept hydrogen as well as electrons from different sources. And if they accept electron as well as hydrogen from inorganic reduced compound, then they are known as lithotrophs. And if they accept hydrogen as well as electrons from organic compounds, then they are known as organotrophs. The first class is the photolithotropic autotrophs. So how we can differentiate that what kind of sources are used by such kind of bacteria? That as in carbohydrates, they already mentioned that they are autotrophs, and I already told you that autotrophs used inorganic carbon as a carbohydrate sole source. Okay, now the second is they are phototrophs. That means they use light as an energy source. Okay, then third is lithotrophs. Then lithotropic bacteria always use inorganic carbon as in hydrogen or else electron acceptor. Okay, now the example, best well-known example for this class is cyanobacteria. So cyanobacteria, again, they are photosynthetic bacteria. So they convert carbon dioxide into oxygen and generate an ATP as well as NADH. So here the photolysis of water molecule is carried out, and in this way oxygen and hydrogen are released. So whatever the NADH is again an inorganic compound, and this is a reduced form of inorganic compound. Okay, now the second class, second example for this class is also purple and green sulfur bacteria. These are nothing but they are anaerobic bacteria, and activity of purple green sulfur bacteria is similar to cyanobacteria. They do photosynthesis but in the absence of oxygen, and as an electron donor, instead of water molecule, hydrogen sulfide is used. So hydrogen as well as sulfur are released, separated in photolysis reaction. Okay, an energy source that is used by such kind of bacteria is again light. The second class is photoorganotropic heterotrophs, and now they told that these are heterotrophs, means as a carbohydrate source they use organic carbon, and phototrophs, that means as an energy they use light, and organotroph, that means as a hydrogen and electron donor, organic compounds are used. And best example for this class is rhodobacter. Generally, rhodobacters are fermentative kind of bacteria, and these rhodobacters generally ferments organic matters and make ATPs from them. Okay, please keep in mind. And the third class is chemolithotropic autotrophs. So as in autotrophs, they use inorganic reduced carbon as in carbohydrate sole source. But it doesn't necessary that sometimes they use only inorganic carbon. Doesn't necessary that they only use a reduced form of carbon. Okay, and chemotrophs, that means they use chemical as in energy and lithotrope. Again, they use inorganic carbon as in hydrogen or electron donor. Best well-known example for this class is sulfur oxidizing bacteria. And actually, it oxidizes hydrogen sulfide. In the presence of oxygen, hydrogen sulfide is getting oxidized. And sulfur oxidizing bacteria example are Begiatova. And another example is nitrifying bacteria. We all are familiar with this, that dinitrogen oxide is oxidized in the presence of nitrifying bacteria. And nitrite is converted into nitrate in the presence of nitrobacter bacteria, and this is again an oxidation reaction. So these nitrate oxidizers are also come from this class. Okay, please keep in mind. Then fourth type is chemo organotropic heterotrophs. So as in heterotrophs, they use organic carbon as a carbohydrate sole source. And chemotrophs, that means they use chemical as in energy. And organotrophs, that means organic substances are used as in hydrogen or as electron donor. And the best well-known example is Helicobacter. So if my videos are useful in your studies, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.